Now this is one mechanism when we use selenium calcium. That means when we use the water in combination with the selenium dioxide, then this is the mechanism to yield diketo compound. So the other mechanism, when we don't use water along with this selenium dioxide, then let us see that mechanism. That means second mechanism for selenium dioxide mechanism is now the compound starting material is CH2CO CH3. This is the starting material. Here two enol forms are possible, but this enol form, that means double bond here, highly substituted alkene is more stable instead of this lesser substituted alkene. So the enol form for this ketone is this one. This is the most stable enol form. Now CO2, HCO2. Now this will come here. This will go here and this will abstract this proton. That means this will be like this. So this will abstract this proton. So that will shift towards that carbon. Now the products are CH O, SCOH, OH, and this side CO CH3. This is the product, that means intermediate. Now this here proton is there, we can write like this. Now this will loses its bonding pair and this will go off, and this H plus and this OH minus combine to form water molecule to yield the desired compound, CH3. That means this compound plus selenium element 0. That means this is black PPT, black, it will form like black precipitate. From black precipitate of that reaction, we can confirm that reaction is completed. Plus water molecule. So this is another mechanism when we doesn't use, means don't use water. But here, if we use water, selenium acid will form and that will take care of that mechanism. So these are the two mechanisms of active methylene oxidation, of active methylene compound. Now let us see some examples of this oxidation of active methylene compounds. Let us see some examples. This is the mechanism involved in oxidation of active methylene groups with selenium dioxide. Now let us see some of the mechanisms. some of the examples. So here, first example, suppose if we have cyclohexanone and if we treat this cyclohexanone with selenium dioxide, then it will generate diketo compound, this one, diketo compound, it will generate this. If we hydrolyze with OH minus, this is like a benzyl, so this will undergo ring contraction this one. So alpha keto acids we can generate from this cyclohexanone. So from here this compound we can prepare. So in CSIR how they can ask is they will just give, and here they will write the compound product. So 1 and 2 they will write from here to here. Okay. Now we can suggest these two reagents. This is one good example of selenium dioxide oxidation. Now second example we can write is, for example, if we have acetophenone, if we have then if we do this selenium dioxide reaction, then this will give CO CH, this compound. Now third example we can think about is here, if we have this compound, now if we treat this with selenium dioxide, then there are two chances are there. This is one and this is one. So two active methylene compounds are there. This is sterically crowded compared to this carbon. So preferentially selenium dioxide oxidizes at this carbon. So this compound will form. This is major and this compound is minor. Now one more example of this oxidation is suppose we have this compound. Now we have done selenium dioxide reaction on this. Then the compound, the product is So here this is actinomycin compound. So this is the compound it will give. So here this is unstable compound. This immediately abstract a water molecule and this will exist in acetal form. Generally, two hydroxy groups on one carbon, those compounds are unstable. Immediately, it will lose one molecule of water and it will exist in keto form. But here, because of two electron withdrawing groups, this compound is stable in this acetal form. Now, this is one example. Fourth example, let us see one more example. So suppose we have this compound this polysulfuric compound we have. If we treat with selenium dioxide, then this will undergo oxidation. This is also one example. Now, if we treat this is beta tetralone, if we perform this selenium dioxide reaction, selenium dioxide reaction if we perform, then here also two positions are there. This is benzylic position, this is not benzylic position. So benzylic positions are more reactive for selenium dioxide. So here this is the major compound. This is the major product which will form. Now let us see one more example. One more example is, suppose we have this compound. So, sorry, this compound, then if we perform selenium dioxide reaction, this will generate carbonyl group at this position. You can generate carbonyl group at that position by using selenium dioxide reaction. So one more reaction is this this tetrabutyl cyclohexanone, for tetrabutyl cyclohexanone, if we perform selenium dioxide reaction, then it will give this compound it will give. Now these are 8 examples. Now let us see what will happen if we use camphor. So here 9th example, if we use camphor, so this is camphor. Now if we do selenium dioxide reaction over this, it will simply generate keto group over there. This is the product. Now one more example. So here, like that, number of examples means a collection of examples we can collect and we can write in our notebook, so that whatever example we get in exam, entrance exam or whatever exam, even CSIR or IAS or means group 1, group 2 exams, wherever these examples comes, we can apply this sequence of reactions or even sequence of reactions with oxidations, then we can find out the nature of product formed. Now one more example I want to discuss is, suppose if we have like this phenyl ring, this is phenyl ring, then SCO2 gives keto group here. This kind of compounds we can generate. So here 11th example, pH, if we get this compound, we can prepare benzene. This benzene compound we can prepare. So here we have seen almost 11 examples, and some more examples we can see. Here suppose we have this dactylmethane compound, this is ET ethyl group, diethyl ester, malonate, so SCO2 oxidation, then this will give this compound. So like this, number of examples we can write for selenium dioxide oxidation of active methylene compounds, which are just adjacent to electron withdrawing groups. So these are the examples. I think those are sufficient for this discussion here regarding oxidation of active methylene compounds. That means the methylene groups which are adjacent to selenium dioxide. So let us see the function of selenium dioxide in allylic oxidation reactions. Allylic oxidation reactions. That means the allylic carbons. That means which are the carbon which is adjacent to an alkene group. For example. This is an alkene and here this is allylic carbon. So if we perform this selenium dioxide reaction over this alkene, then there are possibilities of two products. One is allyl alcohol . Second one is ketone. Alpha beta unsaturated ketone. So in general this compound is major and this compound is minor. So here let us see the different examples of this allylic oxidations. Now these allylic groups are different types. So here suppose double bond is there, here this side one methyl group is there. Suppose if we take an alkene of this kind, then selenium dioxide oxidation if we do, then there are three possibilities here. Either this carbon or this carbon or this carbon. These three are first degree carbons, methyl groups only. No secondary carbon is there here. Three allylic carbons are first degree carbons. So preferentially this selenium dioxide, where it will oxidize if we use one equivalent of selenium dioxide, that is important. So here selenium dioxide always prefer to oxidize a carbon where it is least crowded. That means this is more crowded. That means it is cis to this carbon, so this is more crowded. This E carbon is less crowded. So here in these two methyl groups, this will select this E carbon. This E carbon is more reactive, more selective, rather than reactive, we can say selective. More selective. And here out of these two carbons, this carbon only more selective, because the intermediate carbocation is more stabilized here. So here this kind of intermediate will form in this oxidation reaction. So this is one carbocation, this is one carbocation. So out of these two carbocations, this is secondary carbocation, this is tertiary carbocation. Here number of hyperconjugative structures are more for this carbon. So here number of hyperconjugative structures are less. So this carbocation is more stable. So preferentially here carbocation is stable. So this selenium will oxidize selectively this carbon. So first rule is it will select that E carbon. Out of E and Z carbons, it will select E carbon. That means geometrical isomers, E carbon it will select. And if here two carbons like this, the oxidation takes place where highly substituted olefin generates the positively charged means carbocation. So this is the most stable. So here the product is this one. So oxidation selectively goes to this methyl group, not these two methyl groups, even though these three are primary first degree carbons, methyl groups. How we will see mechanism? After discussing some more examples, we will see mechanism. Now, suppose we have this group, then if we perform, this is first degree, this is first degree, this is second degree. So it will choose, of course, this carbon, and it will more choose if this is a second degree carbon. So the reactivity of selenium dioxide is second degree carbon is more than first degree, then third degree carbon. So here this OH will form predominantly. Now suppose if we take this kind of system. Now from this rule, this is secondary and this is first degree, so where it will go? So first rule, this dominates the first rule, that means E, and where carbocation is more stable. So here also it won't go to this secondary carbon, it will go to this carbon only. Why? Because the formation of stable carbocation. This will form. So this is first example, second example, third example. Now let us see one more example. If double bond is in ring system, what will happen? Suppose this double bond is in ring system. Now SeO2, then here three carbons are there, three carbons. This is one, this is, and this is. Now this double bond is in ring system. So selenium dioxide preferentially oxidizes ring carbon and highly substituted ring carbon. Highly substituted ring carbon. Allylic means this is highly substituted carbon, and this is allylic carbon to highly substituted olefinic carbon. So preferentially oxidation takes place at this carbon. This is the same priority. This is also same priority. Why? Because this is the highly substituted olefin carbon. But here this will oxidize because this is in the ring system. So here the product is this one. This is minor. This is major. Now let us see one more example. If we take alpha pinene, then what will happen? Alpha pinene is this one. This is alpha pinene. Now, if we perform selenium dioxide reaction, here three chances are there. This is one, this is one, and this is one. So this is bicyclic compound, and here if we see, this carbon is more substituted to olefinic carbon, so either here or here it should go oxidation. But this is tertiary carbocation, means this is tertiary carbon, so tertiary carbon is least preferable, so this oxidation preferentially goes to this carbon. That will form major product. So let us see one more example. One more example is beta pinene. If we take beta pinene, this is alpha pinene, this is natural compound, naturally occurring compound. This is terpenoid. This is a terpenoid. This is also a terpenoid. This is beta pinene. Now, if we perform this selenium dioxide reaction, then it will go oxidation over here. This carbon. Why? Because this carbon is highly substituted, and this is second degree carbon, this is second degree carbon, yeah, of course. This is tertiary carbon. So here, because this is more substituted carbon, preferentially that the oxidation will go to this carbon. This is also one example. So these are the examples. Now let us see the mechanism. How this is performing allylic oxidation. So these are the number of reactions. Now let us see the mechanism of this selenium dioxide reaction, how it is performing in allylic oxidation. So here in this mechanism of selenium dioxide with an olefin includes two reactions. One is heme reaction, that means two pericyclic reactions it involves here. So one is heme reactions plus followed by 2,3 sigma tropic rearrangement to give the desired compound, ketone, allylic ketone or allylic alcohol. So here I have written ketone, but here it is alcohol. Alcohol. Major, this is major, and some of the ketone will also form. Some of the ketone will also form. So this is alcohol is major, allylic alcohol is major. So let us see now the mechanism of this oxidation, allylic oxidation. Now the mechanism this is protein plus selenium dioxide. So here also two mechanisms are there. If we use water, then salinous acid will form and that will oxidize the anaerobic position. If we don't use water, then selenium dioxide directly oxidizes this anaerobic carbon. So let us see both. Now first we will see salinous acid oxidation, that means in presence of water. Selenium dioxide reacts with one equivalent of water to generate this salinous acid. Now what we discussed is this